Outfitted with cameras and sensors, this autonomous robot is verifying price signs and looking for out-of-stock items.
These cameras on the side are capturing images of the shelves that are then uploaded to our cloud environment to determine what products are out of stock, what's mispriced, what's in the wrong position.
Inventory is one of the biggest challenges retailers face. Missed sales from empty shelves and out-of-stock items cost U.S. retailers $82 billion in 2021, or about $1.6 billion a week.
So this would tell us that the Snickers is low, and we probably need to get more Snickers dropped from our back stock and brought out to the floor.
Almost half of retailers said out-of-stock items were their biggest challenge in fulfilling customers' orders.
Retailers are spending a lot of money to know what's coming into their stores through their inventory systems. They know quite a bit about what they're selling and that are leaving their stores. But in their stores, on a daily basis, they don't have a very good model of what's actually happening on their shelves.
But an army of inventory robots is being deployed that would help retailers appease angry customers, boost sales, and respond to the ongoing worker shortage. Almost 900,000 retail jobs were unfilled at the end of November 2022. The retail industry employs more than 30 million Americans.
Retailers are competing in a very tight labor market still, and they're often having trouble filling jobs that are more physically intensive, like packing a box or refilling a shelf. So instead, they're using robots in some cases or automation to fill those types of tasks and having people do skills that use their brain, that use some of the skills that a robot would have a harder time replicating.
These robots are really going to help brick and mortar to evolve and capture sort of the new market where you can order online, pick up in store.
The inventory robot market is a $34 million industry. Other companies in the space include Simbi Robotics and Bossa Nova Robotics. So what impact will inventory robots have on U.S. retailers and the livelihood of its workers? Keeping shelves fully stocked has been a full-time job for retailers in recent years. Fewer truck drivers, higher fuel prices, supplier issues, severe weather, and changing consumer preferences have caused a shortage in everything from toilet paper and eggs to baby formula.
The baby formula shortage is getting worse.
Grocery store shortages are back again.
Tonight, empty shelves lining more stores nationwide. Some retailers complaining product shortages are becoming as bad as they were at the start of the pandemic.
An out-of-stock item is when a shopper leaves a store without purchasing what they intended to buy. The product could be in a warehouse, in a different aisle, or on the shelf, but blocked by a sign or display.
The biggest challenge that supermarkets have today is out-of-stocks. Being able to, you know, really handle how to get inventory on the shelves, that's their number one challenge today.
While some issues are driven by supply, demand is also an issue. The rise in pet ownership in the U.S., for example, led to shortages for products like food for dogs and cats. About 23 million American households adopted a pet during the pandemic. And the problem isn't necessarily a new one. A key component of retail operations is having the correct amount of inventory on hand and making it available to shoppers. On average, for every dollar U.S. retailers make, they have $1.35 worth of inventory in stock.
In the old days, 20, 30 years ago, the way of reconciling our data with our reality was to do physical counts. We would send people down the aisles and they would physically count. We'd have six of this item, two of this item. They'd be punching it into a handheld device and it would be flagging anything that was mismatched. This could take weeks.
Not having a product available for purchase, while frustrating for a customer, is potentially disastrous for a retailer. Out-of-stocks cost retailers not just the loss of the initial sale, but in some cases the loss of a secondary sale and potentially the loss of customer loyalty. Confronted with an empty shelf, 20% of consumers said they postponed their purchase, 10% went elsewhere, and 16% shopped online. Excess inventory, in some cases, is an even bigger problem. Surplus inventory is when a retailer has too many products on hand, like a glut of winter coats in the spring or an oversupply of patio furniture in the fall. In many cases, those products need to be heavily discounted.
If we've invested all of our money in purchasing a product that doesn't actually sell, we typically see retailers having to sell it off below purchase cost. So they've lost money on it, but more importantly, they've lost opportunities. Often, if it's truly surplus, it has to be either thrown away or salvaged.
To help manage their inventories, a growing number of retailers, like Sam's Club and BJ's Wholesale, are turning to robotics and automation to beef up their operations. Inspecting store aisles has historically been the job of retail workers who check inventory, verify price tag compliance, and maintain the ideal state of the store. When done by a human, the job is laborious, costly, and not always entirely accurate. Based in San Diego, California, Brain Corp got its start in 2009 as a research project for Qualcomm. Before moving into inventory scanning, it first developed self-driving technology for floor cleaners.
We looked at an application where there was a really high labor component and a very repetitive, sort of the typical robotics, dirty, dangerous, dull task. And that led us into the cleaning industry.
With just 50 machines deployed in 2017, the company raised $114 million in funding led by the SoftBank Vision Fund. Today, it has over 26,000 robots in schools, airports, and hospitals.
We started looking in that retail space and trying to find what are the other problems that our robots may be able to solve.
In 2022, Walmart-owned Sam's Club expanded its relationship with Brain Corp, adding inventory robots to its 600 stores. The dual-purpose machines, manufactured by Pettitt, use technology by Brain Corp to move autonomously through the store, cleaning floors and acquiring data along the way. Robots like this one have as many as 5 cameras used to scan store shelves, as well as 3D cameras to assist with navigation. Customers purchase the physical machine from a third-party manufacturer and pay a monthly fee for the software. The software subscription for a cleaning robot is in the hundreds of dollars per month. The inventory scanning is a little more.
We've got 4 cameras on the side that would be facing the shelf as it's navigating down the aisle to scan it. And we've got another camera on the far side to be able to look upward at what we call reserve steel, sections of the retail stores that have their products on the uppermost shelves.
All that information is uploaded to the cloud. And it's in the cloud where we really have the intelligence layers. So that's where we have models that are trained on making sense of the images, understanding that that's Snickers and this is a jelly bean, for example, but also the price sign information.
For retailers that are adding inventory robots, one of the advantages is they also are collecting a lot more data about what customers do and don't want. By monitoring inventory, they're not just making sure the shelves are full, they're also getting demand signals on what's selling and what's not. And that's one of the things that retailers often struggle with.
A stock keeping unit is an alphanumeric code a retailer assigns to a product to distinguish it from one another. A Walmart superstore, for example, can have more than 100,000 SKUs, compared with a supermarket that has about 30,000 SKUs. Inventory robots benefit retailers in other ways too, like freeing workers to perform other tasks and potentially lowering labor costs. More than a third of U.S. retailers say staff shortages are their biggest challenge.
Now, before the scrubber, all of this was manual. It required associates to go out, scan it into the location, count how much is there, tag in where it is, et cetera. So what this scrubber is allowing us to do is take all this mundane, really routine work off of our associates.
For example, if a grocery chain with 425 stores had an employee at each location making $15 an hour who counted inventory for 2 hours each day, removing that one task could save the business more than $4.6 million annually.
This is where the robots can help out being able to do this consistently on a daily basis, right? They don't call out sick, they don't get tired, they're ready to run on a daily basis.
The median salary for a retail sales worker is $29,000 a year. More than 50 million U.S. workers quit their job in 2022.
I worked in a small grocery store, so if you were assigned the baking aisle, you were walking down, physically counting how many little bags of chocolate chips were in that bin, how many of each kind of Jell-O. It was extremely time-consuming. It was very frustrating.
The precision at which you capture the data is just much higher than a person can do.
Based in San Francisco, Simbi Robotics got its start in 2014. The following year, it launched its autonomous inventory robot, Tally. With more than a dozen cameras, Tally scans between 15,000 to 30,000 products per hour, taking roughly 2 hours to scan a supermarket. BJ's Wholesale at a tally across its 237 locations in 2023. On top of inventory robots, warehouse robots are on the rise as well. Amazon launched its first fully autonomous robot, Proteus, over a decade ago. Today, the e-commerce giant has more than 500,000 warehouse robots worldwide. The warehouse robotics market was valued at $9.8 billion in 2021 and is expected to reach $23 billion by 2027. A similar expansion of inventory-moving robots could be coming to brick-and-mortar retailers.
I would envision the move category thinking about moving products within commercial spaces is on a horizon, I believe, within the next 5 to 10 years.
Because those associates walk all day long picking orders for our members. Well, if we could find a more efficient way to actually bring the inventory to them or bring the order to them, and then they can just, you know, get it ready for the member, we'll be faster, we'll be quicker, we might even be more accurate.
Brain Corp rolled out its autonomous delivery tug in 2020 to move inventory from the warehouse to the store shelf. However, the company found the robot in its current form was too large for many retail environments and said further development was needed.
It's not mature and it's still emerging within the public space for Move. So we've done some prototypes and some testing and piloting with tug product or with Move products within those spaces. I'll say that we're ready to move into that space and capture that market with partners as it sort of emerges.
Everything is the biggest challenge in robotics because everything about it is hard. From the hardware to the motor control to working with the sensors to making everything reliable.
Despite those headwinds, robots could soon be a common sight at grocery stores and big box chains nationwide.
The ability to now have a robot simply roll down that aisle and collect that information on an hourly basis or even just a nightly basis is an enormous benefit to retailers who really do need that information.
What robots can bring to the table is just consistency. They will run every day. They will run up and down all the aisles. They don't miss things by accident.
In general, retailers are trying to become more sophisticated about tasks that they use people for and instead turn to robots that often can do these jobs more efficiently at a lower cost. And that may mean people are doing different jobs, or that may mean that there are not roles for as many people.